But apart from that, solid draft from Team Vietnam.
You know what, Wolf? You know what, Wolf? All your points are taken. I think they answered a lot of Ling gameplay. Like, the Ling is fast. The lineup is also fast. The Ling can provide bursts. They have a little bit of mobility. I mean, a lot of mobility to dodge it. Plus, they negate the regeneration factor. So, yeah, man. In terms of draft, I think Team Vietnam, they're the ones downloading Team Philippines here.
Yeah.
They're the ones who downloaded, I mean. So yeah, there you go.
Ooh,
immediate, so Lito under, yeah, what's happening?
I'm wrong. This is a core Baxia.
From
Team X. Formerly the Thanos player, and Hyde still plays through with the Farsa. This is much better. The invade coming out from Team Vietnam. Who's gonna take the orange buff? That's the bigger question. It goes Team Philippines, who secured it. Magna flickering through the wall. Now safe. They're all safe and sound.
It was T-Dep try. I hope I said that correctly. But man, that was so huge for Team Vietnam, for them to shut down Carl Tizzy once again, delay his farm once again, and it will give Team Vietnam the opportunity to be aggressive.
That's right.
With their lineup, because one thing to take note with the Kufra and the Baksha is that they can immediately engage and disengage just like this. Immediate backup coming in from Team Vietnam. They're trying to protect their orange buff, but Team Philippines, they want it. They want it as well. You steal ours, we steal yours. It's an eye for an eye.
And Cartesi going, the bigger problem though for Team Vietnam in that specific moment, Manji, was that Cartesi was level 4. The rest of Vietnam, they're just level 3. Broly just all reached level 4, but that won't matter. Just the threat of having Tempest Blades really told Vietnam to just back out, get away from my zone, and even if you take away the orange buff from 30Z, because it says, it's not over till it's over. I'm going to steal yours too. An eye for an eye.
This is actually what I like about Steam Philippines. They have a lot of brute forces in their gameplay, in their playstyle. They're always like that. They want to bully their enemies every time, playing mind games with them in the early stages. So with this Steam Philippines, I think they're still up front, but there you go. That is why the Cooper is countered to the Ling. The Ling is now half health. That is the Angela ultimate for the Ling. Is Girl Tizzy gonna be alive? That is supposed to be the Tempest of Blades. Plus the last insanity from Flap Tizzy to kill the master. And I think it's time for Team Philippines to run because Team Vietnam, they want this fight. There you go. Another kill for Team Vietnam. Will they get more? No, it is a 1-for-1 trade.
1-for-1 trade off. Hyde actually jumps in. From the Kufra as well. Nice synchronization of skills getting out from Team Vietnam. It's almost like they were dancing at this point. Now Lusty, level 4 already. Fatal Link's available. Will not be able to use it instantly because the rest of Team Vietnam are just pummeling through. But they have bought time. And I think that's what Lusty was just trying to do, making sure that Carl Tizzy will be ready for the fight or maybe to defend Lord. But while that's happening, the turtle is going to be slain by Team Vietnam. And that's even better when it comes to objectives that they have secured.
Trung Trinh with the surprise! Flicker Tyrant's Rage! Carl Tizzy did not expect it!
Not at all.
And man, he got faked! It was a pump fake for Team Vietnam! And with that, free turtle for Trung Rung Lee and Broly now on a roll, now having the Raptors Machete. Man, Team Vietnam is outplaying Philippines time and time again.
Yeah, a lot of outplays happening indeed, Manjin. And the fact of the matter is that Team Vietnam's lineup, they are easier when it comes to like executing it.
Yep.
Now, the Kufra still pops the free man Tyrant's Rage, but the rest of Team Vietnam says, okay, you didn't need to do that, but you did. So they've lost the turret at the bottom lane. They have fed one kill. And unfortunately, Team Philippines are known to punish these kinds of mistakes from anything that they face.
Trung Trinh, he needs to be careful again. I think he's so pumped in landing those Tyrant's Rages.
Yeah.
So and there you go again, another Tyrant's Revenge! Coast to coast range from Trung Trinh, another pickup!
Look at T-Max.
Uh-huh.
Look at T-Max now initiating. Cartesi is gonna be in the middle of them all. He's gonna be jumped! The stun, oh my goodness, really a mistake in there coming out from Cartesi and another job. Human Titan Strange, and they have initiation. They have the Fatal Link. Zeribo tries to deal damage, but he is just an angel at this point. Flap Teasy sweeping the floor, what? But receives so much damage from the Farsa. Now look at this, Kupra still alive. In comes the mashup, will miss the mark. Flap Teasy will keep himself safe. Lusty dips to the fight once again. Will not find anyone. Oh, the mashup just flickered. Look at the sidestep, and there is the closeout kill coming out from the Claw. Beautiful. Coming out from Team Vietnam. They dip in, they dip out, they go in, they go out. Walks in, walks out, everything, man. They're cleaning the floor.
It is the Karate Kid style of play for Team Vietnam. If you do that in your training, you're gonna be so strong, bro. Team Vietnam. Especially Trung Trinh, this is, man, commended place here, sandwiching Team Philippines in that narrow vicinity. Team Vietnam, they are now again forcing Team Philippines to react in every way possible. And man, they're out-sustaining and out-damaging them. Dude, Team Max also with a great flank as well. Even though I think the X-Borg and the Angela is also a good combo, it was still not enough because T-Deptry, he also has a lot of surprising moves in his pockets. Man, this is Mind Freaks. This is Team Mind Freak coming in from Team Vietnam.
Yeah. This is not over, Doman Jane. You have to take note. Team Vietnam, even if they get like 6 kills now, it doesn't automatically mean that they are leading against Team Philippines. In fact, it's just a matter of 100 gold or so. Look at the Ling, however. Doesn't have a full item yet except from the Raptor Machete. And if you compare him to the farm of the Claw, which is now at 5.1k, that's already a lot for Team Vietnam. They have been able to push the turret up top. Now they will just regroup on the back lines. Maybe secure the next round of buffs at this point.
Man, I also like what Broly picked as his emblem. It is a killing spree to match up with Carl Teasy in the late game too. And man, again, the Claw is easier to use, but that is a good purify coming up from him. Phew, he's too deep here. The purple, it's still alive. T-Max, he will now pop the ultimate, but Hyde is also here. They just want the purple. Give it to me, says Carl Teasy. And there you go. That is an immediate disengage for Team Philippines. Oops.
Like, okay.
Not yet. Nice
timing, man.
Mm-hmm. Nice ultimate. But the T-Deptry is here. He's trying something here, trying to bait out his skill. But Team Vietnam, they will now go for the push. Flap TZ with the last insanity and the Fatal Links out of nowhere for two. But only one will die as the Blazing Duet was enough for Team Vietnam to get a 1-1 trade.
Now the battle for that purple buff retribution coming up for Cartesi is good. Oof. He steps up the cycle and put the damage. More than enough. Oh, Cartesi gets away. Flap Teasy makes him safe. But while that is happening, while the chaos is happening, Masha able to take out the turtle. Now Few in trouble. Does have the Cotton Inferno, but with the burst from Vietnam, more than enough. Flap Teasy tags this Masha. But they found the last insanity. Gonna be stolen by Team Vietnam. That's the orange buff taken by Hyde. And they get another. But the thing of the matter is, Philippines, they're still comfortable with this. Even though they're losing in terms of gold, the fact that Cartesi isn't stopped when it comes to farm and the endless battle now available on him, I think that they are still confident on taking the mid game. But they have to be careful, Manjin.
Yes, they have to, because the Team Philippines, they're known to punish every little mistake that you make in the game. But again, Team Vietnam pumping it up. They're trying to land in damage here for Few and Flap Teasy. Hyde with a good zoning feather air strike for them to secure the tower in the bottom lane. But there you go, the Child Wonder. Look at the minimap. Ooh. Making plays, doing hard work, trying his best to create space for his team.
But T-Max gets the orange buff. Ooh. Nonetheless, I was amazed at that. Maybe Ling's attack animation wasn't available yet, but he did have the retribution. Maybe he did not respect the fact that Baksha can steal it away from him. The case has been closed. But it's still an even game, honestly, Manjin. Even if it's an 8-3 Philippines, if you're looking at the economy right now, it's not that much of a lead for Team Vietnam. In fact, 1,000 gold lead, 1.8k at this point is almost negligible.
Yep, I think it's so. They're still in a good standpoint, but I think Team Vietnam, what they're doing is they're not playing it 5-on-5. They're playing it. They're playing it confusingly. But again, Hyde will pop the feather airstrike. Here comes Stone Bro Lee. Will have free hit everyone. That is of course 2-man fatal. Lens Man to purify. Bro Lee. I mean, will dodge it out. Two heroes again dying for Team Philippines and Team Vietnam. This is now an easy access to the Lord Pit.
You know what? When Vietnam saw that there's like damage coming out from Philippines, they just grouped themselves up. The boat is sinking. Let's group ourselves into five and then put the revitalize in there. T-Max was able to heal everyone. They didn't die. Yep. And Lusty Few, they have received the brunt of the AoE damage as well. Coming out of Team Vietnam and Predator Strike, you have the Blaze and do it. You have the damage from the Masha as well. Put them all together, you have this killing potential for Team Vietnam. Now, the bigger problem for Philippines is after Vietnam wins team fights, they always go for objectives. This is what we're talking about, them being systematic.
The system still works. It's a system. Where is the X? Where is the Y? You cannot answer that because, again, what is the solution here for Team Philippines? The Lord is now in the mid lane. Now the tower will now fall down. We're now at the third tower as Broly once again. Look at the pokes, bro. Carl Tizzy now at half health.
But this is just distraction in the middle. The real problem is in the bottom lane with Masha in there. And Vietnam, look at what they're doing. They're trying to attract and lure Philippines out of their base so that the bottom lane is going to be finished out. And even with just two sentences, man, the turret has fallen in the bottom lane. That's how fast they can do it.
Man, it's like Team Vietnam is exercising attract and contract. I don't know if that's right. I don't know if I said that right.
I don't know, man.
But it rhymes.
Team. What matters is the rhyme. Oh, Hyde is going to be able to hide. Here comes Broly. They want to punish Carl Tizzy now. Carl Tizzy gets away. T-Max looking for an angle. The Kufra actually in a bad spot. Precarious spot even. But in they go with the feathered airstrike. There's not much combination for Team Vietnam as they have not eliminated anyone yet. But they did fend off Team Philippines at this point.
No can do, says Team Vietnam. T-Max and Trung Trinh, they're still here in the top lane. Meanwhile, their allies, the Farza is so far away. But where's the damage for Team Philippines? Where is it, Wolf? Here comes the cavalry, the backup from behind. Bro Lee getting few. Here comes Carl Tizzy. But man, Hyde is still safe, flewing away to safety. You can't stop the system, Wolf! Can't download it, says Bro Lee. Those are normal hits. Normal hits after normal hits. Double kill for Bro Lee. Art of Timmy. That is, of course, a flamethrower for Flap Dizzy. But man, the fire is not burning in the dance floor, except he goes down 6 feet deep, bro. Ooh!
Sit down, Vietnam. You can't break the system because the system breaks you. That's what they're trying to say now. They have shut down the Masha, but look at that combo. Fatal Links is not going to matter as Vietnam will not stop. They have eliminated the Thams. Carl Tizzy will respawn, but will not reach the top because base is going to be taken out. Vietnam takes the 2-0.